The family of Malcolm X will now sue the CIA, the FBI, the NYPD because of the claim these entities engaged in a conspiracy. Judges also believe this happened as well. I'm going to give you some background and significant insight into why this is not outside of the statute of limitation and why the evidence is there today, but was not there before. Let me first take you to the video of the daughter. Here it is.
Now, at the very place where he was killed, his daughter says she wants answers.
For years, our family has fought for the truth to come to light concerning his murder. And we'd like our father to receive the justice that he deserves.
This man, Thomas Hagen, was convicted of killing Malcolm X, along with two other men who were later acquitted.
Black people should realize that freedom is something that they have when they're born.
The family of Malcolm X accuses various government bodies, including the FBI and CIA, of failing to prevent his wrongful death. It's also claimed they concealed evidence that would have cleared the two men who were wrongly convicted of his murder.
And so for this great injustice, we will be filing a wrongful death lawsuit against these governmental entities for $100 million.
I have much more background. Some of you may already be asking, can you even sue the CIA? Yes and no. I will explain that during my presentation of this story. Late prominent civil rights leader Malcolm X, his family, will now file a wrongful death lawsuit against the New York Police Department, the CIA, the FBI, and the state of New York for their alleged role in the assassination of Malcolm X. The $100 million wrongful death lawsuit accuses the government agencies of fraudulent concealment of evidence. That's an important dynamic of this case surrounding the murdered civil rights icon's death. Now, they're suing for fraudulent cover-up, concealment. This is how you get things into court. You don't sue based on rumor or things you cannot actually prove based on evidence readily available. For example, for decades, it has been echoed that a coordinated attempt by all of these agencies led to the assassination of Malcolm X. Well, that may be true. However, when it comes to filing a court case, you get in based on the evidence you already have. They have the evidence of criminal concealment. I will explain that in just a moment. There's more. The lawsuit comes a little over 3 months after New York settled lawsuits filed by two men wrongfully convicted of murdering the Muslim leader. And on the 58th anniversary of his death, the civil rights attorney Ben Crump, who was representing the family, said the exonerated man's lawsuit that claimed the FBI, NYPD, and the New York district attorney fraudulently concealed evidence made way for Malcolm X's daughter to seek legal redress. This is important. Based on the government's admission that they concealed evidence involving the assassination of Malcolm X, the truth of what happened and who was involved has always been critical, Crump said Tuesday. Follow the information. Benjamin Crump, attorney at law, is saying because of this case before, which went down in 2021, because of a ruling from a judge in recent history, it provided the evidence required in order to move forward with this case. There will be some bumps in the road. There's more. Malcolm X was assassinated at the Audubon Ballroom in Manhattan. This was 1965. Crump and his co-counsel, Ray Hamlin, argue that the leader's daughters were traumatized after seeing their father shot 21 times by a group of men. Malcolm left behind 6 daughters. His daughter, Malika Shabazz, died in November 2021. Where I'm about to take you provides significant connection to the then and the now. Put up the picture of the letter written by a former NYPD undercover officer. The letter you're looking at was from 2011. The man who wrote it, according to the estate, is Raymond Wood. Raymond Wood was a black undercover NYPD agent. He wrote this letter as a dying bed confession. It was delivered to the family by the administrator of his estate, another family member with the last name Wood. Raymond Wood, who is now deceased. Crump said Raymond Wood was an undercover officer who was used by the NYPD to infiltrate and discredit black leaders and civil rights organizations in the 1960s and in the 1970s. In this deathbed dying confession, he implicates that the NYPD and the FBI conspired to assassinate Malcolm X, Crump said, adding that the letter indicates Malcolm X's death was orchestrated by the government. There's more. This was back in 2021, all right? The family of Malcolm X has made a public letter attributed to a now deceased former New York Police Department officer in which the ex-cop claimed the police and the FBI were behind the assassination in 1965. This was revealed by Wood that he was pressured by his supervisors. Who are his supervisors? The police, the NYPD, according to him, in the department to get members of Malcolm X's security detail to commit crime. Understand the strategy here. He says this was orchestrated by his handlers, all right, in order for them to arrest the security of Malcolm X. There's more. So that the security would be unable to manage the door security at the ballroom on the day of the assassination. Under the direction of my handlers, the letter says, I was told to encourage leaders and members of the civil rights groups to commit felonious acts, Wood's letter stated. The Statue of Liberty bombing plot was Wood's supervisor's idea, he said. The plot was publicized on the 16th of February, days before Malcolm X's murder. Walter Bow and Khalil Saeed, two key members of the orator security detail, were arrested. At that time, he says, I was not aware Malcolm X was the target, Wood wrote. Officer Wood puts together an amazing tapestry of events. Now remember, he was an undercover officer. He was in possession of information that could have very well been either A, completely confidential given the rules of undercover work, or even classified. He gave a deathbed confession, said, do not deliver this letter until I am dead. Some may ask, why did he not stand up during his life? According to the administrator of the estate, they threatened to arrest Mr. Wood and pin drug trafficking charges on him if he ever spoke out about what happened. As a matter of fact, according to the administrator of the estate, if he even quit the department, they were going to charge him with illegal narcotics trafficking. So his silence was self-preservation. Back to the question in reference to the CIA, can you sue them? The short answer is yes. Long answer is, but you may not get far. Here's why. There's a doctrine known as state privilege, secret state privilege, or state secret privilege, which allows the CIA to basically say, we can't give you that information because it's a matter of national security. This is not a law. There's no federal statute. Courts have interpreted this doctrine to be an extension of presidential authority or a presidential executive action. That extension or that interpretation of this extension of presidential power allows the CIA to administratively decide what information comes out and what information does not. All right, we will bring you details as they continue to develop. Doc, I know you know a lot about this, all right? I would like to hear your sentiment on the suit that's being filed shortly.
A couple of things. I mean, I'm so glad this is happening. You kind of think that there's stories like this that are happening, but you honestly never get to look under the hood. And so think of all the other assassinations like Martin Luther King, for example, that you just think maybe there's some kind of conspiracy. Things don't add up. I don't have any details, but it's just like this is important for the family. It's important for this particular case. It's important because it shows you the threat that Malcolm X posed to society. But it also shows you the coordinated nature of this kind of assassination, where they were arresting his guards the day before. This was a time when there were really tight gun laws. You couldn't just carry a gun around. And so getting guns and just carrying guns into a hall like this. And so it just shows you the systemic nature of things like this. I'm so glad this is happening again to right a historical injustice, really a state-sponsored murder. But I also think it's important just because I think that we have questions about so many similar acts of political violence. And I think really the public has a right to know. So hopefully this case will open the door for learning about other cases.
Yeah, and we're going to continue following the case. I do find it ironic that at the time of his assassination, he had a change, he had an overview that was different than when he started with the Nation of Islam. When he went on his pilgrimage, he came back with a different point of view. He no longer called white people the devil because he said, I went somewhere where white people were my brother. That created a dissension. For some reason, that's when the government got really involved, when he decided to look at the world from a different point of view. All right, we will continue bringing you updates.